Dineshwar Sharma has been appointed by the BJP government as an interlocutor for Kashmir for sustained dialogue. And in this edition of interview, I'm joined by him. So thank you for making time for WION. And let me begin this edition of the interview by asking you, what is the basic problem of Kashmir today?
Basic problem is that somehow people have got alienated, and alienation of the people has to be addressed.
So when you are saying that people have become alienated, it's not as if people have become alienated in past 1 year. Can you put it in historical perspective, where does this alienation flows from and why has it attained such violent manifestation?
Actually, here Pakistan has contributed a lot. If you see right from beginning, right from 1987 election, it is the Pakistan which has been the single factor in providing logistics, taking the youth for training, supplying arms, providing funds in all manners. So that, and it is still going on.
So how difficult does this third angle or the outside angle makes your job tough?
It is very difficult. I know that is a huge challenge. But I am sure that people of Kashmir will realize what harm is being caused to them by some outside forces.
Have you been given any brief by the government in terms of whom to talk, whom not to talk?
No, I have been given complete freedom.
Are you saying that you will have the mandate to talk to Hurriyat, you will have the mandate to talk to the X, you will have the mandate to talk to the Y? It can be of your picking.
Yeah, definitely.
But then how will you, Mr. Sharma, deal with this issue that on one hand there's a security operation which is taking place to ensure that the Hawala money does not reach the separatists, and a lot of Hurriyat leaders are being interrogated and they themselves are one of the stakeholders?
No, at any place, a stakeholder does not mean a few selected people. A stakeholder means entire people of J&K. And some of them might be doing something wrong for which investigation is going on. I don't have to look into that aspect. That is separate investigation, separate operation is going on.
So what sort of stakeholders, if you can elaborate, you are looking for?
I have already commented that all citizens of India living in J&K are stakeholders.
So how will you start the process? You know, people can't come to your room and say that, you know, we are the responsible stakeholders in stock. There has to be some institutionalized mechanism to meet you, or there will be some sort of an institutionalized mechanism for you to meet different people of civil society.
That is being worked out, and I am sure that people will come forward because they are fed up with the situation, they are fed up with whatever has been happening, whatever Pakistan has done to them. I think they will definitely respond and cooperate.
So, you know, you have spoken about Pakistan, but the larger issue which today stands in front of India is radicalization. How serious is that problem?
Yes, we have noticed that radicalization has grown in Kashmir, and that needs to be addressed very seriously. And all, it is responsibility of all of us, people of J&K, people of this country, to see that this aspect is taken care of.
How has this radicalization taken place?
They are also from across the border, through internet, a lot of materials are coming, which is radicalizing the youth in Kashmir.
But then isn't it different from the days when you were in Kashmir?
That time it was not something like radicalization. It was a totally different so-called fight for so-called Azadi at that time, at the behest of Pakistan. Now things have slightly changed.
In what way they have changed? You have observed it from outside also, from inside also. How have they changed?
Actually, radicalization started picking up after ISIS took control in Syria and Iraq. So from then, that time onwards, it was picked up. It was whipped up from across the borders, from internet, from all sides. So that has contributed.
Are you saying that it really poses a great national security risk to the state of India?
You see, radicalization is a major threat, major problem all over the world. It is not only India and it is not only J&K. But J&K being more sensitive, we have to be more careful for J&K.
Or is it because of the fact, because you have been in the intelligence services, with the breakup of the Daesh and the coming back of the recruits there,
it poses
a different challenge.
Yeah, all factors put together. And then outside forces also involved in Kashmir matters. So they will like to create more and more unrest, more radicalization. They will themselves try to add to radicalization in Kashmir so that Kashmir remains disturbed all the time.
Were you surprised, Mr. Sharma, when this unrest started 1.5 years back and students came out in large number? And in your opinion, what explains the sudden coming out of the school children and taking up stone pelting? Why has that happened?
I think that they were pushed to come out on the street. That's what I believe. By interested elements, they mobilize youth, mobilize students, mobilize young children to come to the street and protest. Because that is one weapon that can be used by the interested people, so that if security force take action on any of them, that becomes a huge international news.
How does then Indian state deal with them? You have been part of the services, you have an issue of human rights, but then the other end, the services also take the brunt of violence from the civil society. So where is that middle line, middle path?
I think people of Kashmir will have to realize this, and my job will be to make them realize.
So you have again and again said that your job is to make them realize that how well the Kashmiri interest is well served within the framework of the constitution, and no one disagrees with it. But the painful part, as you have again and again emphasized also, is the third party, which is Pakistan. When you go to Kashmir, everyone says that you talk to Pakistan. So is India supposed to talk to the person which is actually creating the problem for us, or the problem for the Indian Union?
That is a different issue. That is not my charter right now. But people of Kashmir will have to realize that factor is creating problem for them. So they will have to realize that.
So a lot of people in Kashmir said that there were earlier also reports, there were earlier also people who spoke to them. Nothing much came out of it. What do you say on that? Because Radha Kumar, late Dilip Patgaonkar, Mr. Ansari, they were part of the process. Reports were never put in public domain. And it's not known what happened to the reports either.
Let me go and see. Let me go and meet the people. I think I will be able to make some difference in situation in Kashmir.
But have you been given the access to those reports, sir? The previous reports?
Yeah, I am going through that. And that is a good beginning for me, a good basis for me to carry forward the dialogue.
Are you satisfied with the work which your predecessors had done?
Yeah, definitely. They have done a great job.
If I have to ask you, you have served in Kashmir, you were involved in Assam. How is the problem in Kashmir different from Indian experience of Punjab and Assam? Please put that in perspective for an average viewer.
In one line I will say that outside forces are not so much involved in Assam as in Kashmir. So job in Kashmir becomes more difficult.
But outside forces were involved in Punjab?
Yeah, so Punjab has been sorted out, but Punjab also, it took a long time, and the nation had spent quite a lot. It cost the nation quite a lot. So Kashmir also will get sorted out. I have no doubt on that.
But Mr. Sharma, a lot of people, when we asked them, they said talks take place, but there is no implementation of the talks. But there are people, who were somehow part and parcel of various different offices of the prime ministers in this country, who said talks should happen irrespective of the conclusion. Which school do you belong to?
I think through talks, many problems can be addressed. And I will try to ensure that the genuine problems of the people of Kashmir are addressed by the government, by the central government, by the state government. That will be my endeavor.
Your coming to Kashmir is also a fact that there had been a complete deadlock. The Home Minister had gone there a number of times. A lot of people did not come for various reasons. Doesn't it show that sometimes the muscular approach doesn't work in the Kashmir Valley?
I will not comment on this issue at this stage, because that can lead to misinterpretation. Yeah.
Kashmir has also changed in past 2.5 years. You described the Kashmir of 90s, Kashmir of today. Do you feel that the sort of political narrative of national, anti-national has been interpreted in a way in which Kashmiri feel alienated?
There are several.
And social media has contributed also to it.
Yeah. Social media during early 90s, late 80s, early 90s and all, there was no social media. There was not even cellular phone. But now everything is available. Youth are watching. Youth are getting access to so many thoughts, including radical thoughts. So many developments that is taking place. So definitely all those factors have contributed. It is not same in Kashmir as it was in early 90s.
You're saying it's not same, but there are some issues which remain relevant. For example, the human rights issues, they have their life. They had their life in 1980s. They had their life in today. Even today, you know, you have human rights issues in the valley.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. Human rights issue will always remain. It is not only in Kashmir, everywhere.
But tell me, sir, a lot of people say like Yashwant Sinha went, a lot of people went, and a lot of comments came. But one thing which really struck me was that a lot of Kashmiris saying that there is a crisis of acknowledgement. People beyond Kashmir does not acknowledge that there is a problem in Kashmir. How do you see that point being put across by Kashmiris when they say that there is a crisis of acknowledgement, that you does not acknowledge the fact that there is a genuine problem here? How do you see that?
I have, in the beginning itself, I have said that it is a big challenge and it is a major problem for the country, and it is a big personal challenge for me. So there is no question of not acknowledging the problem of Kashmir.
So you are saying that you acknowledge that there is a crisis of acknowledgement?
No, I say that I acknowledge that there is a big problem in Kashmir. So people of Kashmir saying that there is no people in India, they don't acknowledge that. I don't think that is true.
But then you also have an added issue. When we talk about Kashmir, we will talk about Ladakh. There is Jammu, Punch, Rajouri. But there's a vexed issue of the Kashmiri pundits also. How do you bring them as one of the stakeholders?
Let me go and see. Let me go and meet the people. I am hopeful that all the stakeholders can be brought on same board.
A lot of Kashmiris very nostalgically remember the famous word of former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee: Kashmiriyat, Insaniyat, and Jamhuriyat. You have been given the chance by center. How will you instill that spirit of Kashmiriyat, Insaniyat, and Jamhuriyat when you go there as the representative of the center?
I will definitely try to follow the path shown by Mr. Vajpayee.
But the path was demonstrated by Vajpayee in the continuity and his sustainability to talk to an average Kashmiri again and again, despite multiple setbacks.
Let me go and see. My job is to restore peace as quickly as possible and find a durable solution so that it does not keep happening again and again.
Now, before I close this interview, Mr. Sharma, there are two questions which I would like to ask you. One is that there has been a breakdown of sense of ordinariness in Kashmir, ordinary life cycle. How can that ordinary life cycle be restored? Because at months you have colleges closed, at weeks you get schools closed, at weeks you have towns shut down. How do you bring that sense of ordinariness and ordinary cycle for an average Kashmiri back?
Let me go and meet the people. I'm sure that people will cooperate and find out solution for that.
And last question to you. Did you have an opportunity to meet the Prime Minister? Did he say anything personally to you? His message to you for the resolution of Kashmir problem?
Prime Minister is very much feels emotionally attached to Kashmir, and he definitely wants to see that a durable solution for Kashmir problem that's come. He has already announced on 15 August that the problem of Kashmir should be solved by embracing the people of Kashmir.
Did he say that to you?
Yes, he said to the nation.
No, he said to the nation, but did he say something to you before you got the job? Because Prime Minister...
Yeah, definitely he has said that I should talk to them, and embracing Kashmiris is the objective of this government.
Sir, best of luck.
Thank you.
And thank you for speaking with me.
Thank you.